Hello everyone, this is Dr. R. Lakshmi, Assistant Professor of Mathematics, St. Peter's Engineering College. Today, I am here to explain you the basic units of most of the algebraic structures. Because sets are the building blocks of most of the algebraic structures, and the study of algebraic structures is very essential part in the subject of discrete mathematics. As a part of the subject, I am going to explain the topics of sets and relations. In fact, I am going to explain today in this lecture the basic things regarding the sets and relations, which are essential for the learning of most of the algebraic structures. Coming to sets, as we all know, any collection of well-defined objects is called a set, right? These objects may be either numbers or letters or people, etc. And these objects of the set are called the elements of the set. For example, we have a set of natural numbers, we have set of ovals, we have set of people living in a city, and so on. Coming to the notation of these sets, any set can be represented using capital alphabets and its elements are always denoted by small letters. In two different ways, any sets can be described. There are two ways in which any set can be described. First is the tabular form of the set. The second one is the set builder form of the set. In the tabular form of the set, we give the list of the elements. For example, if we specify that n is equal to the collection of the elements 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on to infinity. Because in this collection, the list of the elements in the set of natural numbers are given, this form of describing the set is called the tabular form. Similarly, the other set description form is set builder form. In this form, instead of listing out the elements of the set, we specify the property that the elements of the set follow. For example, capital X is equal to the elements X such that X is a person living on the earth. This set includes the group of all the persons who live on the earth, right? This is an example of the set builder form of the set. Now coming to the different basic type of sets. As we all know, these are the basic sets. A null set. This is a set denoted with the symbol empty brackets or the symbol phi, where there is no element. Right? For example, A is equal to the elements x such that x is an integer where that x is in the open interval 2, 3, meaning 2 less than x less than 3. Next, coming to universal set, a set which contains all the sets under discussion is called the universal set. Sometimes it can also be called as the universe of discourse, and it is denoted by capital letter U or E. For example, in a die-throwing experiment, the universal set U equals to the set of numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So this is about the universal set. Now coming to the next basic definition, subset, also called set inclusion. Suppose there are two sets X and Y such that every element of the X is also an element of the Y. Then we say that X is a subset of Y. If X is a subset of Y such that X is not equal to Y, then we call x is a proper subset of y. When the condition that x not equal to y is not there in x as a subset of y, we simply have to call it as a set inclusion or a subset. We call it the proper subset only when x is a subset along with the condition x is not equal to y. Next, coming to the power set, if A is any given set, its power set is denoted by capital P of A. It is the set of all possible subsets of the set A. For example, if the set A has the three elements 1, 2, 3, then the power set P of A will definitely have always 2 power n elements, where n is equal to 3. Because n equal to 3 in A, there will be 2 power 3 equal to 8 elements in its power set. And the elements of the power set are listed as below. So we have the different elements of the power set of A with 3 elements given by 5, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, 3, the subset 2, 3, the subset 1, 2, 3. These are the 8 subsets which form the power set of the given set A. Now coming to the Venn diagrammatic representation of the set. The graphical representation of the sets is called Venn diagram. In Venn diagrammatic representation, rectangles are used to denote the universal sets. Circles are used to denote the given sets, other sets. Now let us see what are the basic operations possible on the given binary sets using Venn diagrams. First one in this type is the union of AB. It is denoted by A union B and defined as the set of elements X such that X belongs to A or X belongs to B. The corresponding Venn diagram representation is given by, it is given in the graph, it is in the diagram. The rectangle shown for universal set. For the two sets AB, the two circles have been taken. For representing A union B, the shaded portion is shown in this diagram. Similarly, for showing the intersection of the two sets AB through the Venn diagram, the diagram is plotted here. The common portion shaded here is the collection representing the Venn diagram of A intersection B. And that A intersection B is defined as the set of elements X such that X belongs to A and X belongs to B. Now coming to the symmetric difference of the sets A and B, denoted by A delta B. It is defined as the set of elements X such that X belongs to A and X does not belongs to B, or X belongs to B and X does not belongs to A. It can also be defined as the union of A minus B and B minus A, where this A minus B is the difference of the two sets AB. A minus B consists of all the elements X such that X belongs to A and X does not belongs to B. Similarly, we can define B minus A as the set of elements X where X belongs to B and X does not belongs to A. The union of these two difference sets is called the symmetric difference of A and B. The corresponding Venn diagram is shown here. The shaded portion is here. The region representing the symmetric difference of A and B, which is denoted by A delta B. Now coming to the complement of A, the set is denoted by A power C or A dash, also denoted by U minus A, the universal set minus A, the collection of all the elements X such that x belongs to the universal set and x does not belongs to A. The corresponding Venn diagram is as shown here, the shaded portion which represent A complement. Here we have to make a note of the disjoint sets. If the intersection of any two sets is an empty set, a null set, then we say that the two sets AB are disjoint. Now let me explain the example to calculate union, intersection, difference and complement of the sets. Suppose the set A is having the elements 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And the other set let us consider to have the elements 2, 5, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14. The problem is to calculate union of A and B, intersection of AB, difference of AB, symmetric difference of AB and complement of A. Coming to A union B, as we all know, it is the collection of elements which belong to both AB. So, discarding the common elements of AB, we list all the elements which are in both AB. So, we get A union B equal to the set with the elements 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 10, 12 and 14. Similarly, to collect the elements that exist in A intersection B, we collect the elements that are common in the sets AB. And from the given two sets AB, we can clearly see that A intersection B is the set equal to 2, 5 alone. Now coming to A minus B, because we know that A minus B is the set of elements that belong to A and that do not belong to B, focusing on the set A, we delete the elements of B from A and that corresponding set form A minus B. Because the set A is having 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, where 2 and 4, the set A is having 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, where 2 and 5 belongs to the set B, deleting those 2 and 5 of B from A, we write A minus B equal to 1, 3, 4. Similarly, finding B minus A, deleting the elements of A from the set B, we have B minus A equal to the elements 6, 8, 10, 12 and 14. Finding the difference of A union B and A intersection B, or otherwise finding the union of A minus B and B minus A, we can have the symmetric difference A delta B equal to 1, 3, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12 and 14. Now the calculation of complement of A. It is the set, the elements from the elements of the universal set which do not contain the elements of A. So in fact it is the collection X such that X does not belong to A.